still get number one there. In their homework. That says there, Miss Junius bought 2.5 cakes to school for her class. But there are 150 people in the class. I'm sorry, 15 people in the class. Including Miss Junius, how much of the cake will each person receive? So she's bringing 2.5 cakes for 15 people. Okay, so is it 15 divided by 2.5, which is 2.5, or 2.5 divided by 15? Well, ask yourself this. Who's eating the cake? Well, it's 15 people, okay? So are you dividing 15 people by 2.5, or are you dividing 2.5 cakes amongst 15 people? Now, I'll do both, and then you tell me which makes more sense, a logic problem. Okay, so think there. If I'm with a decimal once, because there's no decimals in the divisor, I'm with this guy once. I have to move a decimal over here. And the decimal over here is over here, so we move it this way. Okay, so we got a zero. How many 25s going to 150? Well, how many quarters in $1.50? Six. Well, that would be the answer to this. That means that each person's going to get six cakes. Or six cakes. That doesn't make sense when there's only 2.5 cakes. Okay, so think of logic, common sense here. There's no way that, if there's only 2.5 cakes taken to school by Ms. Nunez, there's no way they're gonna each get six cakes. Doesn't make sense. So, then it must be this one. So, then 15 into 25 is in ones. We subtract, we get 10, we add a zero. 15 into 100 goes in. What is that? Six times, that gives me 90. I subtract, gives me 10. And one zero. Again, 6, 90. Okay, and as you can see, what's going to happen, you see the little pattern here, that's going to repeat. So then, 0.66 is a repeating bar. And so this is how much they're going to get of the cake. So I'm going to put here 0.166. Of the cake. Okay. I'll put it, they will receive. They will receive. They will receive 0.166 of the cake. This makes more sense. Okay, number two. Write a real-world problem that can be represented by the following equation. Remember, this is your constant. Constant. Okay, so think it's the constant, it never changes. So make up a problem. I mean, I'll make one for me. I like bicycling. So I'll say that M is equal to days. M is equal to days. Okay. And I'll say, okay, I ride my bicycle for, I'm sorry, 7 miles each day for 7 days. I ride my bicycle 7 miles, and then it'll be 7 miles each day, okay, for 7 days. M is the number of days. So then that's just 7 times 7, which gives me 49. So I will ride 49 miles, total miles, that's just for total. I will write. I will write 49 total miles. I will write 49 total miles. Okay. So that's exactly what that means. This should be another. Okay. I will write 49 total miles. You come up with your own example. Number three there. Okay. You have a six numbers are shown below. Place each number in the appropriate set. So remember, look at the numbers here. Now remember this fraction. If you can make this a whole number, then you know you can put it somewhere. So think about it. Natural numbers are what you learn to count with. 1, 2, 3, etc., etc. Whole numbers are these plus 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Integers are these, and the negatives. -4, -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Those are the integers. Think about it, where they belong, where these numbers would go. They can go in more than one place. Okay. For example, I'll do one, like positive 2. See, there's a 2 there, there's a 2 there, and there's a 2 there. So it's in all three. Okay. So think about where they go. You have to place those here somewhere. And they can go in more than one place. Number 4. The roller coaster at Fiesta Texas requires riders to be, what is it, at least, okay, so at least 48 inches tall. So the roller coaster requires to be at least 48 inches tall. So write an inequality. Inequality is this. This here is an inequality. Those are the inequality symbols. Okay, those are your 4 inequalities. 1, 2, 3, 4. Inequality symbols. To represent the height requirement. Shade the number line to represent the fifth of Texas. Constraints for roller coasters. This word constraints means the limit. Okay. It puts a limit. Okay. Constraint. Limits. So my inequality would be this. Well, let's say x equals x equals what? Well, height of person. Okay? And so x equals height of person. So that means that the height of the person, x, because this is the word at least, it has to be one of these two. Okay? And so I'm going to put the 48 over here for this. So the height of the person has to be at least, that's this thing over there, because it's one of these, has to be at least 48 inches tall. So that means, are you going to be, can you be greater than 48 and get on the ride? But what if you're less than 48? Do you get on the ride? No. If you're less than 48, you don't get on the ride. Okay, so if you're 47, is this 47? No. So then this is like that. So the height of the person has to be greater than or equal to 48. At least 48. So if you're 47, you can get on the way. If you're 48, you can. And so now this is my answer here. And we're gonna graph it, and I'll just put a 48 here. Is it a closed circle, open circle? It's a closed circle because it's at least, okay, equal to. So I'm gonna put a closed circle. Now the height, these people have to be taller than this. So that means I was going this way. Okay, and that's the answer there. This one here, subtraction. Some of you still don't know how to subtract decimals. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is line up the decimals. Okay, now the thing is, where is this decimal at? Some of you still want to do this. Okay, you do that. You do that, and you're going to get the wrong answer. This is a no-no. Okay, don't do that. It's 26 is a whole number, so it goes on that side. And just subtract it, I'm gonna do it for you. Okay, and then this one over here. Line up the decimals first, okay? Which is bigger, that's a whole number. So it goes over here. And then 0.84. And then just subtract, and you get the answer. Okay, so I didn't do everything for you. Well, okay, see you tomorrow. All right.